And now it's finally time to open the universe window. So what we're going to do is go over here and we're going to open up the universe window. We're going to open up the universe. We'll maximize it here. So now we have a blank universe. First thing I usually do is if you click on edit and then view, it gives you a grid. Now the grid's really going to help us for the positioning of items. And what I normally like to do is go to layout properties and use the maximum resolution of the grid. So in this case it's 50 and 50. Okay. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to insert a background from the actual show site. What's nice to do is take a picture of the stage or the area where the lasers are set up, and then we can take that and put it as the background in the universe. So I'm going to open an image as an example here. We go over to Components, Image, we drag the image over, and we click on the inspector. The inspector is all our settings for each of the components. And we'll go down here to Open. I'm going to open up Picture. I'll take a picture from one of our show sites. There it is as the background, so we can center this a little bit. Good. And now the next thing we're going to do is you can insert your own logo. We like to put our logo at the bottom of the screen so our clients and any onlookers can see our logo. So we'll just add another image, bring it over here. We'll open logo. And we have our logo. We'll just put it down at the bottom. Down there. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to start with our laser projectors. So if you remember from before, we created one called right one and left one. So we're going to select the components, laser projector. We're going to drag it over and place it where it actually is at the event. So let's say if we had a laser projector here. Here's there. Okay, I'll drag it over here. And then we're going to drag another one over on this side. Now, we like to put these little icons as laser projectors in here. So I'm going to include these icons with the files that you're going to get. We're going to add, I'm going to go to the inspector. And in this laser projector here, we can open a little picture for it. So I'm going to give you these icons, which we like to use. So we'll open up this little guy here. We can center it, place it. Usually bottom center is good. I can reduce the size of this a little bit. Make it a little bit neater. So this is one of our laser projectors. And then we'll do the same with this one. We'll open up the picture for it. And we'll center it, place it at the bottom. And then reduce the size a little bit. And place it here. Okay. Now we're going to want to set up or assign the indexes to these laser projectors that we've set up. So if we go to the inspector, we see here that it's asking for projector by index. Now, how do we figure that out? Well, it's quite easy. We can go, we'll just minimize the universe. If we go to Settings, Laser and Emulaser Controller Hardware, we open that up, and we look down our list, we can see, oh, here it is. This is left one and right one, the ones that we've created. Now, left one happens to be index 13, and right one happens to be 14. So we'll just remember that, left one, 13. Go back to the universe. This is our left projector, so we'll set the index to 13. And then the right projector, we'll set it as 14. So now we know our left one and our right one are set up accordingly. Now we're going to position the zones to match these laser projectors. So we're going to go back to components. and we're going to select zone. Okay. So, if we start with left one, we'll grab the projection zone that we created called left one, we'll drag it over. We could place it up here. And then we'll do the same. Grab another one, right one, projection zone, bring it over here. Adjust that. Something like that. Alright, so now, if we press the play button, we can select our zones. Okay, so now that we have our two zones set up, what we can do is we can click on either of them to select them, or we can click on both by holding down Shift and selecting both zones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just minimize this a little bit here and give you an example. So if we select this zone, we can send a cue to that zone. If we select this one over here, we can send a cue to that zone. Or if we hold down Shift and select both, we can send a cue to both zones. As well, you might want to readjust your enhanced reality preview window after you've positioned your projectors here. So let's just select that one there, and then we would see our outputs as well on the preview window.